Hi guys, welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. I am Hannah, and today we are destroying our hair with bleach and hair color because I have gone through a mental breakdown this week, and I figured what is the best way to deal with a mental breakdown than drastically change our hair color. It's really not drastic, but I did change it. So if you guys are interested in this look, I would say that this is pretty much like the Charli D'Amelio look. I feel like everybody and their mom currently has this, but I did it with a two-tone red because I am a redhead at heart. So I had to keep it in the red family. I'm gonna go over products, I'm gonna show you guys how I did it, and yeah. So if you guys are interested in that, go ahead and keep on watching. Make sure you guys do subscribe to my channel before you leave. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get into this tutorial. While I was in the middle of having my third mental breakdown this week, I decided I needed to color my hair. I've seen this hairstyle, I would say it's called the Charli D'Amelio hairstyle, kind of all over, or I think it's called like the halo or something like that, where you basically just color a whole strip around your hairline and color it whatever color you want. While I am a redheaded girl at heart, I decided I needed to do a two-toned red. Once I got the products that I needed to create this look, I went ahead and started by sectioning my hair. Now, while I am talking about this, I will go ahead and insert footage of me doing this. And I just want a forewarning, my hair in this video was so gross and greasy and nasty and disgusting. Honestly, I kind of knew I was going to be doing this, so I did wait a few extra days than I normally would when I wash my hair. She got nasty, but it was just, it was part of the process, so you're just gonna have to be okay with it. I'm really not that disgusting, it happened. Anyways, so I started off by sectioning my hair, kind of getting a piece and a look of everything that I wanted. Now, I know the back of my hair is not gonna be perfect. I am well aware it is not gonna be perfect, but guess what, guys? I'm doing this at home and by myself. While I was actually filming this, I was talking to my sister on the computer, like I was Skyping her at the time. Do you think that the front pieces are too small, or should I leave them a little bit smaller?
I think that'll be good.
Okay.
I don't want a huge pop in the front. We already knew that. Because then it'll just look like a skunk stripe.
What if I want it to be a skunk stripe? And she is a hairdresser, and she was like, you don't really wanted to be perfect, but I think she was just telling me that to make me feel better. I'm pretty sure. Then I took out the bleach. So the bleach that I'm using is the Arctic Fox. This is the Bleach Please Complete Hair Lightening Kit, and this comes with a cream bleach. It comes with a developer, which is actually a 35 volume developer, and then it has a pair of gloves in it. Now with this, I needed way more than one pair of gloves, so make sure that if you are doing this at home that you do pick up a few extra gloves. I actually really like this lightener. I feel like it worked really well. However, we're just gonna have a conversation about it has so many oils in it that it left my hair like sticky at the end. It got better once I shampooed it, but I'm assuming that they do that because it's supposed to be like healthier for your hair. Basically what you do is you mix both equal parts together. So it comes with 6 ounces of developer, it comes with 3 ounces of the bleach, so it's 2 to 1. You mix it together, so if you only use like half of the developer and like a little bit of the, you know what I'm saying. So if you want to cut this in half, you can, but even with the amount of hair that I bleached today, I did use this full thing to do it. With my hair specifically, about a year ago, if you were not familiar with my channel, I was white blonde. Like my hair was white blonde. I was basically, yeah, it was a lot. So from my hair kind of growing out, I have about, I don't know, I would say like 6 inches of my, like the mids of my hair where it's really dark, and then the ends are light because that's where they were previously bleached. So I had to be really careful on how I did this because I didn't want to double process my ends and then have like white, like a white end of my hair, the roots of my hair being white, and then the mids being like dark. It did end up happening that way, but I kind of wanted to prevent that from happening. So I went in with my mids, let that sit on for probably about 30 minutes. And this bleach can sit on your hair for 45 minutes total. So I put that on for about 30 minutes and then I applied it to the ends a little bit, and then I went into the roots and I did my roots. So with my roots, I only left it on for maybe 10 minutes and I was like, I need to wash it out because my roots got so light so quick. But I was still trying to give time for like my mids to really lighten, and they weren't. So I ended up just saying, let's just rinse it out and let's go back in with a double process of bleach. So at this point, you're gonna be seeing me, you know, in front of the camera. My hair is gonna be wet. I went ahead and dried it a little bit. I would say it was about 90% dry, but I didn't shampoo it. I just rinsed it out. I didn't want to close up my cuticle or anything like that. So if you are doing this at home, don't shampoo it and then condition it, because you're just closing up the cuticle. It makes it even harder for that bleach to really like penetrate and open the cuticle back up and lighten things. So at this point, I just went ahead and basically where there was like spotty pieces, I went in again with the lightener and I just kind of went over those mids once again. If I do this again in the future, just because my hair got so light from that bleach, I probably will go in with a soap cap. And if you don't know what a soap cap is, basically my understanding of what a soap cap is from what my sister tells me is that it is just like a lot of shampoo and bleach mixed together. You suds it in where you want to lighten and it'll lighten your hair a few shades. It's not going to give you a total bleach, but it does kind of lighten it. So if like, let's say you accidentally color your hair too dark or whatever, you can kind of go in with a soap cap. I did it with my extensions because my extensions I did do a little bit darker than my hair was taking the color, just because again, it was blonde. Long story short, I did it on there just to lighten it and then go back in with another color. So once I did my second process of bleach, I went ahead and rinsed that out, dried it, and we applied color. The color that I used was the shade Wrath from Arctic Fox. Lo and behold, this is like my tried and true, but this is so bright red. It is like a red red, like a true red red when it is applied to light hair. I am sure you guys can see how light of a red this got. Now, that is the one thing about Arctic Fox that I could do a little bit without, is that they do make the packaging a little deceiving for the color that is actually in there. So if you do want a little bit of a darker color, maybe you can't have this red of hair, which I'm a little afraid to go to work on Monday because I have a feeling they're gonna be like, girl, too red. You could always mix in, I'm talking like a whisper in the wind of black, or maybe a little bit of purple if you want to darken this up a little bit. I really, really like how this turned out, and it is so flippin' awesome. But let's get to the top of my hair. So while I was applying this to the halo around my hair and letting this process, this can sit on your hair for as long as you want it to, because it is so conditioning and it's a semi-permanent hair color. It is also a semi-permanent hair color. With it being a semi-permanent hair color, that means, ladies and gentlemen, it has to be saturated. Like, you have to have so much of this. You can't skimp out on this. It has to hit every single piece of hair on your head. If it doesn't hit every single piece of hair on your head, you're gonna have splotches, you're gonna have spots. It is not gonna look cute, and you're gonna have to do it all over again, which with how much parting and stuff this took, I didn't want to have to do this again. So I made it very, 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 very saturated on my hair, made sure that I hit everything, and really went in pretty heavy-handed with the Wrath on my head. That's all I have to say about that. The next two products that you are going to need to pick up if you want your hair kind of like mine is going to be the Age Beautiful 5RR, which is a medium intense red, and this is available at Sally's. And then I did mix it with a 20 volume, and then I ordered this online, and they just like really, they really tape her. They really tape her up when they ship it. But I did do a 20 volume developer with my red. The 5RR is the color that I normally have my hair, which is the darker part of this situation. And it's the color that I normally use. However, this time I didn't put the red booster in with my color. And the reason being is, although it is a red, like a really intense red, it is still a brown red. So when this fades, it does fade more to like a brunette. Obviously you still get the impact of the red behind it, but in some lights it's gonna look more like a brown hair color than a red hair color. Also, back to the second processing of bleach, I don't know if I said this, I did let that sit on my hair for another 45 minutes. So that double processing, that probably took the most time. And because the Arctic Fox, again, can sit on your hair longer than the color, that's why I did it first. And then I went in with the color and let that sit on for 30 minutes. After I let that sit on for 30 minutes, I went ahead and rinsed out my hair. And this is the lovely and glorious hair that we had out of that situation. And I will tell you, it is gonna take a lot for me to get used to, but I feel like this just adds like so much more dimension. Like, it is so fun, it's so cute. Do I feel like I'm a little too old for this hair color? Yes, yes, I do. I feel like I'm a little too old to be rocking hair like this because I'm not 16 like Charli. I am a 26-year-old lady. I am basically almost twice her age, but I do really like it, and I'm really happy that I did try it because guess what? It's hair, and I guess if I go to work on Monday and they're like, yo, no, 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 I can always go over it with another color and call it good, but I do really, really like this, and I am so happy with how it turned out. It's very much me as a hairstyle, so yeah. I think that's basically it. I know there really wasn't like a whole lot to this video, but I will leave everything listed down below. So if you guys want to purchase any of these products, you can go ahead and do so. Make sure that if you guys did make it this far into the video, that you guys do hit subscribe. Make sure you comment down below, give this video a thumbs up if you guys like how this hair turned out. And I will catch you guys next Sunday for another upload. I love you guys so, so much, and I will see you guys then. Bye guys.